Hello, everybody. Happy Monday. It is our weekly status report for the week of October 11th. I can't believe it's already October 11th. We have been out of our house since June, I think it was 5th, and then on the road technically since July 5th. So we're 3 or 4 months into this, depending on how you count. And it has still been a fun time. We are settling into what it means to be nomads and how to manage our life. We've had some struggles and some ups and downs, but overall, it is still a great time. So we're still in Glasgow. If you remember from last week, we settled into a house sit with our dog, Jessica, a little border collie, outside of Glasgow. And also, I reported some knee problems last week. Those knee problems have continued, kind of laying me up. The good news is I've been able to work on my book, tentatively entitled Everything You Need to Know as a Full-Time Traveler. Or living your best life as a nomad. I don't quite know what the title is going to be, but if you have questions or what particular things covered there, comment below and I will make sure that's included in the book. And also while you're doing that, give us a thumbs up and subscribe. So we're in Glasgow this week. Steve took advantage of, well, not took advantage. I said, Steve, get out of the house. And he said, great. while I laid up my knee, he went into Glasgow and did a walking tour in Glasgow. And had a wonderful time there. Here are some of those pictures going around Glasgow. I have been to Glasgow before and I've done a walking tour, so I didn't feel like I missed too much there. Then the next day, after resting my knee and typing about 10,000 words, we were able to take the train into Edinburgh. We're still trying to debate whether it's called Edinburgh or Edinburgh. Anyway, the city that starts with an E, that's the capital of Scotland. Went over there, had a blast, beautiful city, walked around, listened to a band called The Spinning Blowfish, and I'll put in some little audio here, and you can actually listen and watch them for a minute. And then we found, Steve did a little research on the best bar in Edinburgh to taste whiskey. There's a ton of whiskey tasting experience that are really catered to the tourist crowd in Scotland. We didn't want to really do that. We could have paid £25 or something to do the Johnny Walker whiskey tasting experience. Most of the distilleries right now are closed because of COVID, so you can't actually get to a distillery. You have to kind of go to a bar and do a little flight or whatever. We actually found this really great bar called the Bow or the Bow Bar, B-O-W. And here comes Jessica. And went in and told them what kind of whiskey we like. So I said, you know, I like bourbon. And they brought me my first whiskey. And it was okay. Here's a picture of it. And then Steve had one too. And then I came back and I said, give me something completely opposite of this. And they said, all right, you want something peaty, something really strong, something really with a really aftertaste. And they gave me this next one. I can't pronounce these, so if anybody wants to pronounce them for me, you go right ahead. And I loved it, exactly opposite of what I thought I'd like, and I loved it. So little experience and making sure you get out of your tasting box and try something new. So that was a lot of fun. And then we saw the castle and saw the Queen's House where the climate, the UN climate conference is coming up where Biden and Merkel, or not Merkel, the new German chancellor, who I can't remember the name, is going to be here. And just kind of fun to be in location prior to all those folks coming into town. So then for the last day, we went over to the local park and went on a little walk and caught some fall colors. My knee is still acting up again, so I'm going to have to take a couple days off. So this week, we are in transition. We are going to rent a car, go see St. Andrews, go see where John Muir was born, make it to London for a couple days, and then end up at our last house sit for England. So lots going on this week. Follow along. Make sure you see us on Facebook and see us on Instagram because we post a lot more pictures there throughout our day. Talk to you guys soon. Again, let me know what should be in the book, Full-Time Living as a Nomad. full-time living as a full-time traveler, life as a nomad. What should that title be? Talk to you guys later.